This is World of Concrete 2019 coming to you from the Las Vegas Convention Center. And folks, I'd like you now to meet Donna Lacquadera Carr, who represents Dodge Data. Welcome aboard.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for taking time out of a busy day.
It's a pleasure to be here to talk to you about this.
Well, Dodge has been around so many years. It's really well known within the construction industry. And the data and information Dodge provides to the industry, I think, is almost untold.
Yes, yeah, we've been around since 1890, actually, when we first started collecting data. But we're not just a lead organization anymore. The analytics piece is every bit as important. We specialize in thought leadership. We specialize in understanding the industry, not just reporting on it.
Well, sure, we all use Dodge data information. There's no question about it. But you started off into a new realm now. And give us an idea, if I can, I'll hold this up for the camera. And tell us what this is all about.
Sure. So we have partnered. I work on smart market reports, which are market research for the construction industry. We research with contractors in this particular case using our own contractor panel. And we do a very large report, about 40 to 60 pages on safety every 2 years. This report, it came out because they were interested in just following up on some interesting new topics, just some things they wanted to know about, little odds and ends of information. We did two surveys, and then the data was so interesting, we thought it was really valuable to get it out to the public. So we created this small brief that really focuses in on some of the key data points we thought were most interesting.
Well, give me an idea exactly what this contains. Is there specifics on various types of construction, concrete as opposed to, let's say,
No.
OEMs or something of that nature?
No, it is a little bit broader than that. When we do any kind of breakdowns, we don't have any breakdowns by industry here. We have a breakdown by size and by type of firm. So we compare GCs to trade contractors, and we compare small, mid-size, and large firms.
Ah.
But it is a pretty broad range of construction that covers both, commercial construction and infrastructure. So
can you give us an idea what you discovered?
Sure. So we have three sections. We did discover some very interesting things about safety best practices. We focused in on two areas to feature in the report. One is on physical injuries due to lifting and the practices that aren't being done quite enough there. But where we really found an enormous gap is in contractors really dealing seriously with noise issues. Even something as simple as wearing the appropriate noise canceling headgear, even that was only done all the time by less than 50% of the contractors.
Really?
So, even things that you think are common practice are still not that widely done.
Even with that big umbrella of OSHA up there saying you've got to do this
exactly.
X, Y, and Z.
But noise isn't really as well regulated, I don't think. So, but in general, they're not taking advantage of the opportunities to think in advance. Buying low noise equipment, that was a very low level of activity. Isolating noise behind barriers, also kind of a low level of activity. So there really is a huge opportunity, we think, for the industry to realize that there's so much more that they can do. I think contractors take very seriously the health of their workers, but noise has always been considered just an accepted part of a job site.
Right.
As CPWR has quoted, there are serious, serious safety implications to that in terms of their hearing.
Well, isn't that interesting? Now, what about sight or eye protection, that sort of thing? Did that come into your realm?
It did not.
It
we
did
didn't
not.
Look at that. Except,
okay.
As I said, we were looking at very specific things that they were very interested in pursuing that had to do with their own educational programs that they were putting out.
Yeah.
Once we left the basic safety practices realms, we had two other areas we focused on. One was the importance of leadership on the job site, the importance of the supervisors, and how essential they are to safety. And while there is relatively wide recognition of this, what's really interesting is the third part we focused on, which is lean. We discovered that contractors who have a large knowledge and engagement with lean are much more likely to recognize the importance of that leadership at the field level, that leadership in safety, that it has to be you know, come from the bottom up. It has to be the people who are the supervisors. And if you think about the basic practices of Lean, that makes sense, right? Because while Lean can often feel top down, once everyone's on board in an organization, then it starts percolating bottom up. You know, then you really improve your practices. You really eliminate waste on a job site by listening to the people doing the work. So there's a fundamental understanding with Lean about the importance of hearing what the people say who do the work. And that's why the leadership of those on the site, not those back in the office, is really what they recognize as what can help bring about safer
jobs.
Although
the ones back in the office are the ones going to be implementing this whole entire...
Absolutely. When we did a report with CPWR a couple of years back on a safety culture, and we definitely learned that to have a strong safety culture, it has to be top down and it has to be bottom up. If you just have one or the other, it just doesn't work.
Yeah, just doesn't work.
Yeah.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
Well, if I can, I'm going to take and read this.
Please, I hope you do.
Because I think it'd be interesting to find out for myself exactly what you're talking about, and following best practices, so to speak. That's the whole idea of this.
Exactly.
And to get contractors on board. Did you find it readily accessible and available to you?
Yes. We have a contractor panel. So we are able to do research that we can control for, you know, making sure it's geographically covered very well, that we get a full range of different sizes, that we can focus in on the industries that we're seeking to. This one was a very broad focus, but we can be more focused with this panel. So it's a great opportunity to do very quick research across a broad base and really understand. We had about 200 respondents to each of these surveys. And, but really very carefully covered, very carefully, so that we could look at them by size. Because, of course, one of the other findings, although this isn't terribly surprising, is that large firms are consistently doing these practices more than small firms. And it isn't just the things that require a real level of money and investment in people resources. Sometimes it's things as simple as having rules about how heavy something can be, where you need either assisted lifting or you need more than one person lifting. Just even having simple rules in place like that, we find it's much more common among large companies than small companies. So
really
we think, you know, there's, and if you don't mind, there's one last thing I'd like to highlight, and it's a good thing to sort of really make sure everyone understands. There's one question, actually a pair of questions we asked in this study, where we said, you know, we gave them a list of all these free resources online from CPWR and others that are available to help with these issues. And we found that a very small percentage were using them. With one exception, it was less than 25% of the contractors we surveyed were using these across the board. But we found that consistently, 2/3 to 3/4 of those using them find them very valuable. So there's a real missed opportunity to take advantage lot of these resources to help improve safety. And, you know, especially for smaller contractors who really struggle with finding resources to do the things they want to do with safety.
Simple things that come apart.
Exactly.
Exactly. Donna Lacquadera-Carr, thank you very much for sharing your message.
Sure.
It's a pleasure. Dodge Data does wonderful work in this industry, and I hope your stay is wonderful.
Thank you very much. It was a real joy to get to talk to you about
this
today.
Thank you. From World of Concrete 2019.